The materials you'll need today will be 2 sheets of paper, a pencil, a paintbrush, watercolor paint, and a water cup filled with water. Today we're going to explore painting our skin color using watercolor paint. Before we start painting, there's a couple of things you need to know about your paintbrush. It should always stay at a point, just like a ballerina. It can go side to side, front to back, in a circle, or even back and forth. But you never want to push up or down with your paintbrush. Yikes, when you do that, that actually hurts the paintbrush. So make sure you're always keeping it at a point. The other things we need to know is that with watercolor paint, you never want to have too much water. So when you pick up your paintbrush and it looks like the water is about to drip down, you can just swipe it on the edge of your water cup, just like that. See all that water coming out? Now you have the perfect amount of water on your paintbrush. Now when you're getting your watercolor paint, you're going to make small swirls inside that color. It's almost like you're tickling it. You never want to dig a hole in your paint, otherwise you'll have too much. Now I'm going to get my watercolor tray ready for painting. To do that, I'm going to swirl my paintbrush in the water, swipe it on my water cup, and then swirl about 2 times in each color. Then I'm going to wash my paintbrush because I want to keep it bright and I don't want the colors to mix. And you're going to keep doing this for every single color on your watercolor tray. We do this to help get the watercolor paint ready. Otherwise, it can be kind of dry. So sometimes it just needs a tiny bit of water to get it ready for painting. Now, we're going to practice making different skin colors using all the colors of our paint tray. So we're going to start with brown, and you just need 1 dot of brown and paint it on your paper. Now we're going to wash your paintbrush, swipe it, get 1 more dot of brown for our next experiment. Wash the paintbrush, get 1 tiny dot of green, and then add it to that brown. And now we're going to go on to our next experiment. So brown, 1 tiny dot of blue, mix it in, move on to the next experiment. 1 dot of brown, 1 tiny dot of yellow, 1 dot of brown, 1 tiny dot of orange, 1 dot of brown, 1 tiny dot of red, 1 dot of brown, 1 tiny dot of purple, 1 dot of brown, and last but not least, 1 tiny dot of black. And you can see what happens when you mix all of those colors with the brown, because skin color are all just different shades of brown. So we're going to use these experiments that we just made with each of those colors to help us come up with our own skin color. So first thing, you always want to leave your hand out because we want to make our own skin color. So mine is going to look different than yours. I like to put my hand next to my paper so that way I always have an idea of what my skin color should look like. So we're going to start with brown. And maybe I need it to be darker, so I'm going to add some more brown. If you need yours to be lighter, you're just going to add more water. Normally, if we were using a different type of paint, we would add white to lighten the skin color, but because we're using watercolor paint, we can just add water to lighten it. So I'm using some yellow and some orange, and I'm adding a little bit more brown to darken it because when I add more water, it gets too light. And you're just going to keep experimenting until you come up with the closest color to your skin color. It doesn't have to be perfect, but just try the best you can. If you come up with a combination that works really well, you can use your pencil and just write down the colors so that you remember all the different colors you used. One reminder before we start painting is when you're painting on your paper and you start to see little fuzzies like this, especially when it starts getting on your paintbrush, that just means that you need to stop because that part of the paper is getting too wet and it could turn into a hole. So you just need to stop and then work on a part of the paper that's dry. When you have been able to mix your skin color, you can go ahead and trace your hand on your second sheet of paper. So go ahead and take your pencil, place your hand on the paper, make sure you're holding still and flat, and you're just going to trace your hand. When you're done, use your watercolor paint to paint in your skin color. Remember, you're always going to start with a color brown and then add other colors to make it your skin color. You can use the sheet that you practice on before when you were making your color experiments to help you mix your colors. After you have finished painting your hand, you can now paint the background. So you can paint the background any way you want. I'm going to add an outline around my hand, but you don't need to paint it like I am. You can make any color or any design for your background. Have fun!